Mega Bonus in front. Denfield Super Eagle, Golden Luck, Mega Bonus for Atsini. He's going to get a win. Best Lamb three lengths away coming after him, and then came Reliable Profit, but Best Lamb for Andrea Ratzani's grabbed him, taken over, and Best Lamb too good. Lucky With You's in the lead, Flying Ace out now, Dream Winner, Bundle of Charm up the rail, Lucky With You in front, and Lucky With You! Packing Bowl is going like a jet. Four on Maniac and Self Improvement, and Packing Bowl, that is a very good win.
Well, Andrea, we're here with the famous Hong Kong skyline behind us. You've been here for 4 months now. How are you finding it?
Yeah, no, it's been quite good, actually. When I first arrived, sort of late August, beginning of September, the weather was quite different. It was very hot and very humid, which took me by surprise because I'm not really used to this. Obviously, I've been to hot countries like Dubai and whatever, but the humidity was very high, and it was hard work for the first few weeks, especially because as soon as I arrived, I go straight into it, you know, track work, barrier trials, and getting the horses ready for the start of the season. So it was challenging, and also at the same time, you had the jet lag to cope with. But it's like anything, after a couple of weeks, everything was fine.
And how did the opportunity come about?
I was in Moulton, the village just outside Newmarket, and I was actually walking the dog, and the phone call arrived. This Hong Kong number, I didn't know who it was. Yeah, one of the members of the jockey club got in touch with me, and they were looking for a full-time jockey to come to Hong Kong for at least 6 months. They were interested in me, obviously, because I was losing, obviously, the Shaker Bay's job. I became a freelance jockey this year, and they thought, obviously, it was maybe a bit of a chance for me to come back to Hong Kong. And like I said, I didn't expect that phone call, and it came to a bit of a surprise, and I thought about it quite carefully, and I sort of came to a conclusion that maybe it was a good idea for me to try Hong Kong.
Was it a hard decision to leave the UK?
It was very hard. Like, I would call England, obviously, my second home. I've been there for 17 years, riding for 15. So that's where everything started for me. So it was never easy. Listen, I haven't gone forever, I don't know, you know, you never know in life what could happen. But it wasn't an easy decision to live in England. I love English racing, that's all I knew, and obviously I've got a house there, a lot of friends, and it, you know, for me it was a different sort of challenge.
And how different is the lifestyle over here compared to back in England?
It's a big difference, because in UK we obviously race in 6 to 7 days a week. We spend 4 to 5 hours per day in the car. And, you know, when they're here, you're only racing 2 days a week. You race Happy Valley on a Wednesday night and Shatin on a Sunday. And that's never going to change. So at least, you know, Wednesday you're a Happy Valley, Sunday you're a Shatin. And the travelling, it's not as much. It's near nothing, really, because the only time we get to travel is half an hour to Happy Valley from Shatin on a Wednesday. So that side of things is a big change, not having to travel as much. Also, the way they race. I think the average distance as well here, racing between 1,000 metres to a mile, you know, okay, you've got the odd race over 1,800, 2,000 sometimes, a couple of races of a mile and a half. So it's a lot sharper and quicker. They race a lot tighter here than they do back in England or in Europe. And the gate's very important here if you get a good draw. And also, you know, the shows are very strict. They expect you to be very clean,
yeah,
you know, during the race. And, you know, you've got to be very careful what you do. And so that was a big change. And I must say, actually, I was quite surprised how sort of quickly I adapted to the style of racing.
Drom Beg Banner with 100 to go. He's two on Dancing Code. Find My Love and Beauty Live all there for Miners. Money's right. He wins again.
Drom Beg Banner. Andrea Ratzani. Don't worry about going green, just go whack brown in one shot and win.
The leader, though, is still I Give. He's out by two lengths. I Give is still in front of Cotton Fingers, and you just can't beat him. I Give makes it five in a row. I Give him a high five.
Money for Jam. Double for Andrea Ratzani, and I Give is unbeatable.
You've got a lot more time for yourself, and I've upped my training, my fitness,
okay,
big time. I'm a lot lighter now than I was when I was in England because
really?
The weights. Yeah, I am. And I feel much better somehow. You know, the weights are quite low here. And I sort of, when I arrived, I was trying to use my weight as an advantage too. I thought if I can do a little bit lighter than some of the big boys, there's a chance I can get on slightly better rides. So I got my weight probably 4 pounds lower, maybe even 5 pounds lower than I would have been walking around in England every day. And but yeah, you know, it's, I do a lot of hiking, training most days. There's some beautiful places to go around, you know, some nice beaches, some nice restaurants, and we hang around, you know, with a lot of the jockeys or whatever. Usually once a week we get together, we go for a lunch or just to spend time together. But obviously the missus is here, so we do a bit of shopping too.
And just looking back to your early days, Kingston Hill, he was really the first horse that put you on the map.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. Like I've always said, every young jockey, when you're starting off your career and you're doing well, but you need just that one horse to sort of make you switch to different sort of stage, which is also very, very hard to, you know, come across and very hard to find. And I was very lucky. I started riding for Roger, and then Kingston Hill came along as a young horse, as a two-year-old, and I ended up winning the maiden on him. And then he ended up winning the Autumn Stakes as a two-year-old. And then, when he went and won the Racing Post Trophy, so that was my first Group 1 winner in England.
Kingston Hill is fairly powering clear and is stretching them right out here. He remains unbeaten, 3 out of 3. Caps a great season for Andrea Atzeni and Roger Varian. Kingston Hill.
And he was closely followed, Andrea, by Postponed.
100%. And then that's your next step. You know, you find the horse, a good horse, in the likes of Kingston Hill, that puts you on the map. And then your next step is to find a champion, really. I think Postponed, when he was good, he would have been one of the best horses in Europe, if not even like worldwide, over a mile and a half on grass. I thought that when he won the Shima Classic, it beat Duramente. Duramente was one of the best Japanese horses at the time. He won the Derby. And when he won the Coronation, he beat Found by 7 lengths that day. I think on his going day, he was as good as any. So he was, if you ask me, the best horse I've ever ridden is probably him. When he was good, he was very good.
It's Postponed in front. Duramante's giving chase, but he can't make up any ground on Postponed, and Postponed is too good.
And the club do seem like to keep the jockeys that got contracted here in Hong Kong through the season. That seems to have relaxed a little bit more of late. And is that something you'd like to explore? Might we see you popping up on a horse at Royal Ascot, for example, at some stage?
Well, you know, we've seen that obviously now lately, especially for the boys, you know, you Bowman and Zach as well, they've been flying into Australia for the big races, which now you're allowed to. And I'm sure if something good came up, and the club are always quite helpful to at least to talk about it. But no, they're a little more flexible now for jockeys going to ride abroad. So if there's a chance to ride a good horse somewhere, I'm sure we can talk about it.
Well, you're based here now. You've been here for a few months. It's the next chapter of your career. Have you set yourself any goals or targets or things you'd like to achieve while you're here?
Not really. I came here and I didn't expect anything. I came here, I didn't come here thinking, I'm Andrea Tierney, I rode over 1,000 winners, I rode 30 Group 1 winners. I didn't come here with that mindset at all. I came here as, I'm a new guy, I'm going to start from zero and, you know, work to get to where I want to get. And I didn't set myself any targets. I just wanted to get the ball rolling as quick as I could, which sometimes it's never easy, but I was lucky. I rode a win on the second meeting straight away.
Mega Bonus in front. Denfield Super Eagle, Golden Luck. Mega Bonus for Atzeni. He's going to get a win, and Mega Bonus beats Super Eagle.
Well done to Andrea Atzeni, who's back at the winner's circle here. He's had a stint here in Hong Kong in the past.
I'm really enjoying it, and you know, racing is good. It's tough, but I'm really enjoying the racing, and it's like anything. You'd love to land on a good horse eventually.
And how hard is it to adapt to getting rides, and how hard is it to get yourself on a horse?
But that's another thing. I've always had an agent wherever I was based. When I was obviously in England, I had an agent when I went to America, and when I was in Dubai, anywhere I've been, I had an agent sort of working for me. When here actually in Hong Kong, you've got to book the rides yourself. So I'm sort of starting to get around things. Obviously, you've got to ask for the rides. Form, you got to try to find a horse that you think is at the right mark, at the right weight, where maybe the top of the boys can't ride it, and then I can just try to jump in with my weight advantage to get on the horse.
Simply Maverick for Andrea Atzeni has opened up by 4 lengths, and he's clearing right away. Simply Maverick has bolted up.
I must say, actually, physically, I've never felt as good. I think it's because I don't spend as much time in the car. I love to stay here for as long as I can, I'm really enjoying it. You know, racing is good, prize money is unbelievable. The club has been very, very helpful, the jockey club. So, you know, I'd love to stay here for as long as I can. And but like, it's like anything, you never know what's around the corner. 4 months ago, I was walking a dog in Moulton, and then 4 months later, I'm in Hong Kong. So you just never know what could happen. But yeah, I'd love to stay for as long as I can.